What is Koha? Well, it's a community and it's also software.
It's the world's first open source integrated library system.
So it provides for librarians the functionality that they require to conduct their library operations, to be able to register patrons, to circulate materials to patrons, to be able to describe their collections.
But it was the first, and to me it's the biggest, and I still think it's the best open source option.
Entonces, en ese sentido, como todos los productos que son open source, son algo que cubren una necesidad, digamos, y son buenos en ese sentido para la sociedad en conjunto.
Who works in Koha? I think it's everyone. It's everyone from that shelves a book, even all the way down to the people that actually write the code.
L'avantage de travailler sur ce genre de produit, c'est d'avoir une communauté de développeurs qui se retrouvent à tous les coins du monde.
Participa muchísima gente, es una comunidad muy muy rica. Tenemos una gran cantidad de bibliotecarios que participan de distintas formas, algunos haciendo control de calidad del trabajo de los desarrolladores, otros ayudando a sus colegas en listas de correo, en canales de chat.
Se trabaja a lo largo de todos los usos horarios. Entonces es importante coordinar eventualmente los trabajos y hay reuniones periódicas que se realizan para que la gente justamente participe, cuente qué es lo que está haciendo y de alguna manera logre coordinar los trabajos.
Koha is an open source integrated library system. So it an integrated library system normally consists like of modules like checkout, patron management, acquisition, serials, reporting, things like that, and we all have that in Koha.
Escribir.
Edit.
Reporter.
Help.
Traducir.
Koha.
It started as a project for a small library in New Zealand that had a year 2000 problem. So they had a system, it wasn't going to work. They needed a new system. And so I worked for a small company that decided to write a system for them.
En la época en la que se usaba sistemas muy muy viejos que fallaban en el año 2000 y se les ocurrió a este consorcio crear un software de cero partiendo de la base de que tenía que ser libre.
We decided to make it open source because we were a software development company. We didn't want to be sellers, so we wanted to keep writing code. So we decided to make it open source and hopefully other people in the world would start using it as well. We had only 3 months, so we had to do it fast.
Après la première version de Koha, donc en l'an 2000, il y a toute une communauté internationale qui a commencé à rejoindre le projet, dont j'ai fait partie des tout premiers non-néo-zélandais à s'impliquer dans Koha.
Al principio era más que nada un módulo para poder prestar libros. Y después le fueron agregando funcionalidades.
Antes usábamos sistemas muy enlatados, muy cerrados. Cargábamos por una parte, prestábamos con otro sistema. Ahora es todo junto, es mucho más fácil.
Le projet a pris de plus en plus d'ampleur et est devenu un vrai projet international avec de multiples informaticiens et bibliothécaires qui participent à son développement.
The principles of Koha, I think, are to be a free and open community, to really let the actual users, you know, the patrons and the librarians of the project really have a voice.
Openness, sharing, flexibility.
And it gives freedom to the librarians to mold the software to their wants and needs rather than just using what someone sells them.
Generally, every type of library can use it, like it's not limited to one size or one type of library. If you look at that and it meets your needs, like it has the features you need, you can use it.
librarians are able to contribute ideas, they're able to report any problems that they have, they're able to request enhancements.
El rol del bibliotecario, nuestro rol fundamental es el servicio al usuario. O sea, nosotros hacemos todo para que el usuario tenga la información.
So COHA helps build that bridge to ensure that anybody at any time, anywhere can read what they want, can research what they want, can find the information that's valuable to them so that they actualize as a person.
Aujourd'hui, ce projet est toujours un projet qui est très communautaire, c'est-à-dire qu'il n'y a pas de structure officielle qui porte le projet COHA. C'est tous les gens qui sont volontaires de par le monde qui contribuent à le faire évoluer et à le diffuser dans le monde.
The importance of CoaCon or any COHA event is that we get to talk to each other face to face, and normally we only have chat and we have mailing lists, and of course it lacks the emotion. I mean, you can use smileys, but there's things you can't express, and once you have met someone you have another picture of them in your mind, and you know what they're like, and you know, you see them when you talk or chat with them, you see their faces. And it's different.
CoaCon is essential. Without face-to-face contact, there is a part of the human spirit that lets you relate over distance.
I think it's a great opportunity to get to meet the people that you interact with virtually every day.
It has an amazing breadth of diversity, the people from all over, which I think is really interesting. So it's, I find it very vibrant and exciting. I like talking to people from other countries that are using the software and finding out how they use it.
It's a different thing each one, but it's always it's reaffirming those friendships. Often, sometimes you can, like at the Hackfest here, put us all in a room and someone will come up with an idea and someone else goes, that's a good idea, and things happen really fast.
To have that opportunity every year to come together and to work side by side is just marvelous. So it's very valued, very, very treasured, I think, by everybody who participates in it.
A mí COHA me da, por un lado, una forma de vivir. Es mi trabajo, tengo la suerte de trabajar en algo que me fascina. Y por otro lado, me lleno de amigos. Es lo más importante para mí. Tengo amigos en todo el mundo.
I've enjoyed every minute of my involvement in the community. It's such a wonderful community of people. It really is the spirit of COHA, I think, that keeps us all coming back and keeps us excited about it.
Je pense que c'est un logiciel qui a un bon avenir et un projet qui a un bon avenir devant lui, parce que justement les gens sont très intéressés par ce produit qui est en constante évolution et qui avance rapidement.
Satisfaction, más que nada. Es muy lindo poder hacer algo que ayuda a otros y además que valoren y reconozcan, digamos, lo que uno hace.
I'm grateful every day that I get to work with this community, this group of people, and definitely the software. I think the software is great.
I can work with what I love, and that I can bring together, like being a librarian and also being interested in technology and being a bit geeky. So it's a good mix for me, personally.
For me, it was actually having control over what I could do. And with COHA, I had complete access to everything, and I was actually able to look at the code and understand what the business logic was behind it. I think that it gives us all freedom, that we're not stuck behind doors with a proprietary system or something that's not very public.
Freedom. So freedom to access your own information.
COHA es, de alguna manera, la puerta de acceso hoy en día de lo que son las bibliotecas y, por ende, el acceso al conocimiento.
I think it's a really good tool for social change.
C'est un système où tout le monde est gagnant si tout le monde joue le jeu.
I choose to be part of COHA.
J'ai choisi de faire partie de COHA.
Je suis COHA.
Je suis COHA.
I am COHA.
And we are the COHA community.
We are a COHA community.
Nous sommes la communauté Koa.
Nosotros somos la comunidad de Koa.